I'm going to show you how to set up Dropbox. Click on my web browser. Type in Dropbox. Enter. It will search Google. First link, dropbox.com, or that's for Teams, Dropbox. Download Dropbox. Save. Saving it in my downloads folder because that's the default location. Alright, I can either double click it from here and run, or go to my Windows Explorer, under my favorites, click downloads, and that's where it defaultly downloads. I'm going to double click it from here. Check run. This is saying this is a program, can be dangerous, do you trust it? I'm saying it's all good. Same thing. It's just saying welcome to the setup. Install. It's going to close the browser right here. Close my file explorer. This Windows installed new updates. That has nothing to do with this. I just installed updates before. What the crap? Okay, never mind. I guess I had to kill Explorer or something. It's almost like it logged off and then logged immediately back on. If you don't have a Dropbox account, set one up. I'm not going into that because I have one. Clicking here, next. Here's where you put your email in and password. Computer name is DJ MacBook. That comes from Windows. The name of this computer, actually. Go to computer, I'm right-clicking, properties. DJ MacBook is the computer name. I did that when I set up Windows. Close. You can name it whatever you want. I'll put in this info and hit next. Okay. It just sent a security code to my phone, which is behind the computer, and I enter that code, it lets me in. This is the double authentication thing. I chose to do this because it's safer, pretty much. And you don't have to do this every time you start your computer or anything. It's just when you install it on a new computer, or if you log into the website, I will enter this code and hit next. All right, here's the thing. I'm on this laptop, which it's a MacBook, and I'm running Windows 7 bootcamped on it. I don't have that much space available on this Windows side. I just want to sync my documents, but I have several folders in Dropbox. I'm going to go to Advanced because I want to tell it what I want to sync. I don't want to sync the entire thing that's like 200 gigabytes or something. Click Next. Installing there is fine. You can choose where to, if you want to put it somewhere else, you can put it somewhere else, like my main gaming PC. I have an SSD with Windows installed and a few games like Battlefield, Age of Empires, and I have a separate 1 terabyte Velociraptor that I keep all of my files on. And I had to tell it from here to install it to that drive instead of the SSD, because the SSD is like 128 gigabytes, and that's about it. Anyway, this is fine here. Next. I want this computer to sync all of my folders. No, I want to selective sync. Click that. Here are all my folders. Just uncheck the ones that you don't want to sync. Update. You could go to Advanced View and select subfolders within these folders. Like my music has tons of subfolders. I could just check like West Coast Rap or something and just get that on the computer. Just kind of a way to manage your storage. Anyway, I just want the documents. Update. Actually, I have a couple of websites I need to manage. I'll do it from here. I'm going to sync documents and websites. Update. Hit install. This will just show you the tour of how things work. I'm just going to click through it, or just, you can skip tour. I'll just go through it. This is just saying Dropbox is a folder on your hard drive and it syncs to the internet. You can access your files from the website or on your computer or a phone. Normally the taskbar is at the bottom. I put mine on the left. It knows that and it's pointing to it. That's pretty cool. Anyway, that's the notification area. You can share folders with people. I'm not worried about it. I'm not going to do it. I've had to do stuff like that. Working in groups at school, I invited them to Dropbox, gave me extra storage. We got to share a folder with our documents. And so we would all be working on this project. We could update the same files, and it would sync across all of our computers. It's a neat feature. I don't need it at this moment. And that's it. It's set up. I'm not going to open it now. Doesn't matter. Okay, linked to Dropbox. Close that little guy. Notice the little spinning circle arrows or something down here. If there's a check mark there, that means all the files are synced. Right now, it's downloading the file list. And if you want to access your files, you can just double-click this. It's Windows Explorer. It'll bring up a folder of Dropbox. It's downloading all those files, and it's also downloading Windows updates. That should slow it down a bit. I'm going to show the settings on Dropbox. You can right-click, go to Preferences. You can do all these things, too. It'll show you the recently changed files. You can launch the Dropbox website, open the folder, which is what happens when you double-click. You can pause syncing. We're going to Preferences. Because I have multiple computers on the same LAN, local area network, the computers will communicate, determine what one computer needs, and send it over the network, which is much, much faster than downloading it from the Dropbox service. I don't like this camera upload feature. It might be good for some people. I'm not going to play that game. I will say, ask me every time, because I like it that way. Okay, save. That link just took me to the Windows settings. I'm not going to click on account, but it's going to show account information, and you can unlink computers, things like that. If I wanted to take Dropbox off of this computer, I would probably want to unlink. One example is if you sell the computer, you don't want people having access to your Dropbox. You can use the unlink feature, and they won't be able to get to it. Bandwidth. Do not limit. Apply. It's proxy stuff I don't mess with. Advanced. That's how you get back to selective sync. If I wanted to add other folders, you can get back to it through that. You can move the Dropbox location. I'm not going to do that either. This Dropbox started syncing over LAN. See how much faster it is? Over 1 megabyte a second. Instead of having hours left to download, it has 20 minutes. Now it has 17 minutes. It's a meg and a half. This is the alert you get when Dropbox finishes syncing. It's usually just a couple of files unless you're setting it up on a new computer. If I modified one of my files on a different computer, it would pop up on here saying this specific file was updated, added, deleted, whatever. And that's pretty much it. Dropbox is great. The end.